Vienna, June 2010. I spent last night with an Austrian filmmaker who has just released a movie on living purely on prana. In the beginning there was light, and I must admit to feeling such appreciation and even a little awe at what he'd managed to put together to get funding from the Vienna Film Society and the various bodies that have supported him in his project. Seeing his movie and the fact that he had over 200 hours of footage from travelling all around the world to interview people like myself and Zenaida Baranova and Prahlad Jani in India, and then all the doctors and quantum physicists and more, the list of people involved from the scientific and medical community also is quite astounding. And my heart, of course, was singing to see it presented in the way that it has been presented, opening our audiences now up to the possibility that, hey, people all around the world now are choosing this type of nourishment. To see also not just the editing and the way that it was put together and his determination, but the grace that flowed with him to allow him to have access to all these people all around the world in the way that he did, having met with me a few years ago in Germany and followed up many of the recommendations that I gave him on people to connect with regarding this, to go and listen to their stories. I found myself also learning many things in watching the documentary, which has now been presented at the Cannes Film Festival and has been picked up for distribution in many countries through Europe. It is very similar to what the Bleep movie, but again, it goes into a whole different paradigm and yet has similarities in that it does close the movie on the power of the mind, with Rupert Sheldrake basically saying that we live in an energy body of mind as one beings connected, which is in metaphysical terms more a knowing that we have connection to a group mind, a universal mind, a divine mind that our physical brain is also connected to. This sort of reality then makes working within the energy fields very, very easy to understand, and how we can live on prana, and that chi follows mind, and all the things that we have shared in our research manuals over the past 16, 17 years that we have written about this subject in various ways. I find myself now just waking in the middle of the night in that semi-dreaming, semi-sleeping, semi-alpha brainwave, theta brainwave, receptive state, downloading constantly data and insights about how to work with this universal mind, just to command and breathe back to our being at this point where our consciousness is housed in physical form. All the data and everything that we need to serve us as we serve in the unfoldment of this world at this time, to be together in ways that expand each other and the usual things that we say. Every night on tour, this tour, I have found myself just tuning in on deeper levels to the interdimensional realms to receive greater insight in field harmonics, universal and global, and also personal when we gather our individual groups together so that we can be effective in our service to each group. It is an astoundingly clear and yet very, very subtle energy that we can work with when we see that our whole being is not actually solid but more a looser group of molecular structure through which rivers of energy constantly run. Rivers with different rhythms and beats, rhythms of love, for example, a pulse that is always running through every part of the matrix of creation and is constantly running through our own molecular and atomic structure as well, and rivers of energy that have that pulse but also have another flavor, which is infinite wisdom attached to it, that there is actually nothing that a human being can't achieve when they really surrender and go into that state of at-one-ment with these rivers of energy that are so pure and perfect that are running throughout the matrix of creation. to invite them, as we are always sharing, to really rise within our own being and deliver into our being the perfect nourishment streams we need, whether that be emotional nourishment or mental nourishment, physical nourishment, and so forth. These rhythms that are constantly running through us are so pure and they are so perfect, and as we have always shared, have the ability to take away all human hunger on the deepest, most base level, and thus free us from the baser ways of operation that we have known to date in the physical world called planet Earth. So for me, it's been such a gift so far traveling on this tour, because every situation I find myself in, I meet with unexpected gifts of people who come and share what they've been doing and creating and what their guidance has been, and manifesting things in the way that Peter has been doing over these last 6 years that it took him to put the film together the way that he has, and now have it released in the world. We know how quickly consciousness can change through movies, as we've seen through The Avatar, and now to know that this DVD, this documentary, this movie is out there is also absolutely fabulous to witness, and brings great joy to my heart to have all this validation in the way that we are now being supported. Of course, it makes our work easier on so many levels. This is Jasmine Heen for the Embassy of Peace, reporting from Vienna.